In this video, we are going to learn about statement and block, and we will see Python indentation. We will also see what are the common indentation errors, and we will learn how to address them. Then we'll see what are the best practices to follow and how we can use them. I am going to share with you a very important takeaways at the end of this video that every Python programmers need to know, regardless you are a beginner or an intermediate student. Let's find out after this intro. Welcome to another video. My name is Ajay. If this is your first time here and you want to learn programming languages or enhance your coding skills from beginners to professional, you are in the right place. We will cover plenty of other programming languages and the best practices, tips and tricks which will help you to grow in your career. Then start now by clicking the subscribe button and the bell notification. Alright, in last video we have seen Python keywords and identifiers. If you have not seen that video yet, I strongly recommend you to watch it first, then continue with this video. You can find that video in the card section. For this video, we are going to use the Visual Studio Code to see all the examples. So, the three terms which we are gonna talk about, they are not specific to Python. You can find these terms in all the languages. So, these are basics, or you can say these are the core of any programming languages, which is keywords and identifiers, statement, and block, or some people call this block of code. Let's understand these terms with simple example to get more clarity on that. In our English language, there are 26 letters, and group of letters form a word, and group of words can form a sentence. If we have more than one sentence, it becomes a paragraph, right? Likewise, in programming languages, we have a keyword and identifier, which are the same as word in English language, and the statements, which are group of keywords and identifiers, and more than one statement becomes a block of code. So here I have created an example. I just wanted to show you this example so you can easily relate the things. So in programming world, keywords and identifiers nothing but a word, and the statement is a sentence, a single line of sentence. And if you talk about the block of code, that is one or more sentences combined together, so that creates a block or block of code. So as we can see in this example, this particular line is a statement, and here I have defined a function called greet which contains more than one statements, so this is a block of code. Now I believe you get the point. I hope by now you have the clarity about the keywords, identifiers, statements and block. Now let's move and talk about Python indentation. In Python, it's all about the indentation, which is space and tab. Python use different approach to structure their code. In Python, programs get structured through the indentation, and this principle make it easier to read and understand other people's code. Keep in mind that one thing which is unique to Python is that spaces, tabs actually mean something. In most of the programming languages, spaces and indentation are just used to make the code look better. But in Python, it is actually part of the programming language. Putting in an extra space, leaving out extra space where it is needed, will generate an error message. Now let's understand the Python indentation in more details. So as you can see in this image, we have a block 1, block 2 and block 3 and so on. So this is a perfect example of indentation. They are indented properly. By visualizing this image, we can easily see that the block 2 is a child of block 1 and the block 3 is a child of block 2. So this makes very clear which blocks come under which block. So block 1 is a parent of block 2 and block 2 is a parent of block 3. So we have covered most of the theory, and now it's time to move on. Let's see a program to understand how this indentation properly works. So I have written down a function, simple function. For now, you don't need to understand what this function do here. So it is not required to understand each and every line of this function for now, because we are just starting it. We'll move one by one and gradually you come to know. So let's see this example. We have a function called greetMe, which is expecting one parameter. So see here, consider this is a block 1, this is a block 2, this is a block 3. Right, and see how they align. By visualizing this code, we can easily see this is a block 1, this is a parent block of if block is a parent of this print statement, right? And here we have continued with the print statement, which is continuation of second block. So make sure to give a proper alignment. As you can see, there are four spaces with parent and child, and if statement is a parent of this print statement, and we have a same number of spaces. So make sure throughout the program you are maintaining the same number of spaces and you are aligning your code properly. So now let's go and talk about the Python indentation errors. So we'll see three types of indentation errors: expected and indented block and unexpected indent. So these three indentation error we'll cover. Now let's go ahead and reproduce those indentation errors and we'll see how we can fix them or how we can address them. So the first indentation error is expecting an indentation block. So let me first write a code. So the approach we are going to follow here, I will reproduce that error and see how we can fix them, right? So I have written that code and I will just go ahead and save that file and let's try to run that and let's see what error we are getting. So here you can see that we are getting indentation error, expected and indented block. So what this error actually tells, Python is expecting some indentation, but we are not providing the proper spaces. And as you can see, we are getting the indentation error in line number 2. So we have seen that parent and child concept a few minutes ago. So if you are getting this kind of error, please check you are providing right amount of spaces between your codes or not. So how we can fix that? It's pretty simple. Just go to that particular line and provide a proper indentation. Save that file and rerun it. Your program should be running that code. All right. So we have seen the first indentation error. Let's go and see the another one. I will just quickly go ahead and write a code. So the next indentation error which we are getting is unexpected indent. That means Python is not expecting any indentation or extra spaces in our program, but we have accidentally or unknowingly provided that space. So whenever you are getting such indentation error, please make sure you are providing proper indentation or proper line and spaces. So how we can fix that error? We can go ahead that particular line and eliminate the extra space. We'll save that file, we'll run. Now we are not getting any error. Now let's see the another example. I will just do a slight modification in this code so we can utilize it for saving some time. I will save that file and let's try to run it. See, so the another indentation error which we are getting is saying the indent which we have provided is does not match with outer indentation level, right? So in this block of code, the indentation we have provided to this particular statement and this particular statement are not matching. So there are mismatch of spaces. So if you count here, we have a 1, 2, 3 spaces, and if you count spaces here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 spaces. So there are mismatch of spaces. So if you are getting such error, please make sure you are providing equal number of spaces throughout your program. Now let's see how we can fix that. It's pretty simple. Just provide the equal number of spaces in your program. Let's save that file and run it. Voila, the program runs successfully. So we have seen three types of common indentation errors, what they mean and how we can fix them. So now you know how to fix indentation errors. If you are getting any other error, let me know in the comment section. So here we come at the end of our video, and before ending this video, I have prepared a simple quiz for you to check your understanding. We have two files, file A and file B. You have to tell which file code having indentation error and why. I'm expecting it to be fair. Now pause the video and try to find out and let me know if you find that error in the comment section below. Thank you. If you enjoy this video and would like to support my channel, make sure to subscribe and turn on the bell notification so you won't miss anything. Thank you so much for watching this video and I see you in the next video.